Trying to get some action. There's no action yet. Walk away from me if you don't want to hear it. You're going to hear it.
He knows how to hold it.
Ryan Bannon! Oh.
Well, I guess it wasn't.
Go, 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 Brandon, go, go, go.
Oh, no.
Oh, my gosh.
Get the pitcher,
Good time.
They call him safe? He's out.
They called him safe?
Take what you get in this league, don't you?
It's Samantha Lixton's dad. Her mom is keeping score, I think. All right, good hit. Nice hit! Lefty.
Go!
Oh wait, let me see this. Please get him out. The throw. Oh, circle. Oh, he's running him down. Who are you?
Thank you.
I don't know who
says you are. Hi,
Bubby.
Go hard. Kyle, three.
Yell Brandon in a minute. Have him look this way. I got him on the
same place.
At the end of the game. Number 12, Brandon Smith. Player of the year. I'm going to have to control myself on this if he hits a good one.
Did I make a score?
Over. Why do you even ask him?
Brandon, make me. Make me pitch good this game, Brandon.
Give him words of wisdom, Dad. Come on, Brandon. Hit a homer. All right, Brandon, go, go!
Don't stop.
Go, Brandon, run!
Don't stop.
Oh my gosh, where did it go? Go, Brandon, go! Run, run, hard, run! Go, go!
Wait, Brandon, stop, Brandon!
Oh, gosh.
No!
Oh, man.
What did the kid stop for?
That's foul ball.
Man, they're just lapping. Stop. That's game.
Good swings, gal. Good cut. Good swing. Good swing.
I told Brandon whether he wins or loses, he has to shake the hand of the other team. That's good sportsmanship.
I gotta stand up.
step, keep on.
She knows some people that's Amish. And they wear, in the winter, they wear three hats.
She doesn't know where you're coming. Yeah, zippers down, I think.
60 or 70
pounds. Always
down.
They don't have one.
Oh, Brandon, watch the ball.
Hey, you running the pictures out there? You take the pictures? I'll let your feet move and after that ball. Watch the
ball. Watch the ball now. Be ready. See you later.
There she is. She up on the hill. Go, go, I see her. Good job. Well, Nathan, stop both of them going to Brandon.
We had this like tube of wildflower seeds, and most of it was grass. And
we go up, but I don't think it's good.
Go, Holly, go, Holly!
Are you
Yeah.
No, no, not again.
You don't. Hey, go.
I need to come to Indiana.
All right. Good job. Nice play.
Watch home, watch home, Drew, watch home.
He always runs him down. It's run him down, Drew. You know, I think.
Dry over here.
Nice hit!
Get out there and coach first, Karen. Karen? Get out there and coach first, Karen.
Off the bag.
Go, Tony!
You got time, you got time. That's a bad call.
Take the base!
Good. Man. Brandon. Like the Canal Days Queen or something. I think Daddy might know these people though. Lakey Bikes.
I'm giving it first so I can lay mine on it.
Thank you. Let me see you. See, I see the clown.
I see the clown!
Here they come! There's a whole bunch of clowns! Oh, go shake his hand, Charles.
I'll go with
their hand.
Look at the one with the ducky, Charles.
Shake his hand. Okay, thank you. What do you want to see, Chelsea? Chelsea, what do you want to see?
I see the tractors.
The tractors. Oh, and there goes the bubbly. I should have got that on tape, him fielding it.
Chelsea over there
watching.
Go, Brandon, go!
Be quick!
I'm coming!
Be ready.
The only thing is when you're looking through this, you can't see what's going on. Where is it?
Ask her for faults.
Yeah, let me do this. Oh, I can't see him.
Be ready.
I need everyone to shift the band.
Thank you. It's going to get hotter. There you go. You're reaching.
Seventh pitch, Brandon. What do you have to do? No matter what I do, what do you have to do? What? Swing at it and make that ball hit back, right? I hear he got his first home run last
season. Bases are loaded. And they're ready to run. Take him out. Oh no. Oh right, nice hit. Run, Brandon, run. Run hard. Go, Brandon, go!
Wait, Brandon! Wait, Brandon! That away.
Go, Brandon! Go, run!
You got one of those.
You can re-see. I mean, see what you've
yeah,
done.
It's one of those little video cameras. Get Nathan. Let's get Nathan. Can you put closer? It's Nathan.
Oh.
His thing's right in his eyes.
Don't let him go, 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 go! Right!
Stay, Lydia!
Gosh. Lydia got a double.
Yeah.
Oh, interference.
Here comes Lydia.
Oh, Lydia!
Good job! Hold it! Hold the ball!
All right! Oh.
No, no, no.
Strain it out, Quentin! Come on!
Yeah!
You gotta go! Brandon.
Get ready.
Come on, Brandon.
Don't stop. Did you hear him call foul ball and you were still standing? I want you moving until he calls you back.
She's right here playing with Deb's girls. Go, Dwayne! Run! Nice hit! You got the out, guys. One more. Stop it. Stop it. Come on, Brandon! Swing threat!
Nope. She's smart.
Oh, yeah. Go, Brandon! Go, go!
Try, Lydia!
Go, Brandon!
Go, go, Lydia! Go, go!
Stop, Brandon! Stop!
It's 9.
You can do it. I was hard to see if I'm sitting over there because it's sun. Yeah. Yeah. Way to watch.
Hold on.
That's why it's hard. Oh, that's why it's hard.
Oh, swing a good one, Drew!
What dinosaur movie was it?
Go, 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 go! Go hit, go hit!
Alright!
That's it. They just made it. It's 10-9. I would think they won. And they were home team. Hey, Bob.
Yeah!
Leave it alone. You can screw stuff up.
Trophies, I want you by the numbers.
Okay.
Just show them we know by the numbers, okay?
Oh no. Was 9-7 going in that last inning?
What do you weigh?
The bottom of it.
That's what Nate weighs!
He did during basketball.
Oh, yeah,
I got a second place trophy.
You get to second, and you know, come on.
Have fun every time you came to the ball diamond. We're very proud of our success in our three goal areas, all of the right stuff we can run us up the.
Hey, Mom, Dad would be proud.
Thank you.
special. It's by Carrie Lesher, and it's Via Della Rosa. And the Via Della Rosa is the street that Jesus took to the cross. Is that right?
Via Dolorosa in Jerusalem that day. The soldiers tried to clear narrow street, but the crowd pressed in to see a man condemned to die on Calvary. He was bleeding from a beating, there were stripes upon his back, and he wore a crown of thorns on his head, and he bore with every step the scorn of those who cried out for his death. Down the Via Dolorosa, on the way of suffering,
next special is Justin Gardner, and he's going to play Great is the Lord.
Once again, the crucified arose, victory. The crucified arose, and the grave became a place of hope for the heart to sin and sorrow. Is beating once again for the heart that sin and sorrow broke. Is beating once again.
Thank you, Justin. And now Mary's going to play her violin. And were you there? Some may say that Jesus' resurrection is all the credentials he needed for the Christ, and I would respond This was his reward for obedience to the cross and is our hope. It also would remind that Elijah was credited with raising the dead, that some predict the Antichrist may fake resurrection, and that there is little Old Testament reference to resurrection. In contrast, God went to great lengths to help identify his son and his plan for the cross while yet concealing it from Satan. Some say, any place you cut the Bible, it bleeds, and I'm inclined to agree. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, you sent your Son into this world to steal our hearts away out of the hands of Satan, to keep us and to hold us for our good and your glory. May this message be given and the hearing be to that purpose. In Jesus' name, amen. John 4:23, and Jesus said unto the Samaritan woman at the well, "Ye Samaritans worship, ye know not what. We Jews know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshipers shall worship in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him." Here Jesus affirmed God's desire for man to worship God enthusiastically and with true knowledge of who he is. After his resurrection, Jesus walked on the road to Emmaus with two of his followers that did not recognize him. Luke 24:25-27. Then he said unto them, "O fools and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Ought not Christ to have suffered these things and to enter into his glory? And beginning at Moses and all the prophets, he expounded unto them all the scriptures, the things concerning himself." Following Pentecost, Peter and John went to the temple and began preaching by saying, "The God of Abraham and their fathers have glorified his son Jesus." In Acts 7, Stephen gave an historical account from Abraham through Solomon. And at the island of Crete, where Paul survived the poison snake bite, he preached the holy nation of God and the law of Moses, that they might believe Christ Jesus. What was told by Jesus, Peter and John, Stephen and Paul, that their hearers might believe, that they might have true knowledge of who he is? Were they sharing foreshadowing pictures of God's redemptive plan through his only begotten Son? Is the common thread to the knowledge of God and his creation spun through the understanding the shed blood of this Son? Does his shed blood reveal the innermost character of our Creator, and is it used by him to shape our understanding of his holy and perfect balance of justice and mercy toward us, that is, his love for us? At the failure of obedience in the garden, Adam and Eve were ashamed. They now knew both good and evil, but could they choose to do good without God? What could they do to reconcile the relationship with him? The creation was fresh, and everything was God's. What could they offer? They tried to hide. And God painted his first picture of the plan of reconciliation of man to himself, the plan of salvation. God slew innocent animals, the first deaths, and made coats of skins as coverings for Adam and Eve. In Hebrew, the words for coats and atonement have the same root, katran, meaning covering. At this same scene, God foretells the atonement through blood he had just modeled here in the garden with his words to Satan. From Genesis 3:15. "And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel." The Redeemer will suffer the cross to his death that included the nail piercing of his feet, but this will manifest to be only the bruising of his heel. And God said to Abraham, Genesis 22:2, "Take now thy son, thine only son, whom thou lovest, and get thee into the land of Moriah, and offer him there for a burnt offering upon one of the mountains which I will tell thee of. Verse 9, and Abraham built an altar there, and laid the wood in order, and bound Isaac his son, and laid him on the altar upon the wood. Verse 10, and Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son. Verse 11, and the angel of the Lord called out, lay not thine hand upon the lad. Verse 13, and Abraham lifted up his eyes, and behold, a ram caught in a thicket by his horns. And his previous words of faith in verse 8, just spoken to Isaac, echoed with new meaning for all of Israel's history. My son, God himself will provide a land. Abraham called this place Jehovah Jireh, meaning God provides. And the mission of God's covenant with Abraham that through him all the people of the world would be blessed is now woven. The scarlet thread weaves another picture in the fabric of Israel's history with Moses, whom his wife Zipporah took a sharp stone and cut off the foreskin of her son and cast at his feet and said, surely a bloody husband thou art because of circumcision. This she did while Moses had second thoughts to follow God in the appeal to Pharaoh for Israel's release from oppression. By this Abrahamic covenant custom, she acknowledged to no longer be a Midianite priest's daughter and had cast her lot to follow this Hebrew God and his deliverance plan. Pressured by both God and his wife, Moses now conceded. With a willing Moses, God initiated his wrath in a series of plagues, allowing between each plague time for repentance, while yet commanding obedience. To escape God's last plague of wrath required the obedience of placing the lamb's blood on the doorpost of the houses. This is a vivid picture of the salvation to escape God's final wrath of hell, requiring the heart's doorpost to be covered with the lamb's blood. This picture was celebrated in the Israelites' Passover festival for over 1,000 years prior to the coming of Jesus. Faithful to what God modeled in the garden, both Abel and Noah offered acceptable sacrifices because they contained blood. But God rejected Cain's bloodless offering. When Abraham's seed increased to a nation size, God continued this sacrificial picture in the highly ordered manner of the tabernacle. When entering the tabernacle, an Israelite's attention is captured by the brazen altar, which burned continually with the sin offerings. This was a constant reminder of man's fallen nature and that innocent blood had to be shed on his behalf, as it was in the garden, to make it possible for man to enter the place of blessing and fellowship with God. This continual sacrifice was to cover only the unintentional sins. All sins, deliberate and many others, were covered once a year on the most sacred and holy day, Yom Kippur, the Day of Atonement, when all the people were to appear before God. As their representative, the high priest approached the veiled room, housing the Ark of the Covenant, which contained the tablets of the Ten Commandments, and was covered by the mercy seat. Cleansed in prayer of repentance, the high priest prepared to enter into the special presence of God. Blood from a goat, called Sa'ir, the same Hebrew word for lamb, was taken by the high priest and sprinkled before and upon the mercy seat. Thus outside, blood sacrifice was continually before the eyes of God. And inside, closest to his presence, blood atonement was necessary for man's cleansing from all sins. God continues to tailor the thread from Abraham on its divine direction through King David, whom God declared in 1 Samuel 13:14. A man after his own heart. Though he testified much on the handiwork of the angel of the Lord, I found only one scripture where an angel of the Lord appeared to David. In that appearance, God knitted his tabernacle with its sacred altar and court into its final home. Note the site. From 2 Chronicles 3:1. Then Solomon began to build the house of the Lord at Jerusalem in Mount Moriah, where the Lord appeared unto David his father, in the place that David had prepared in the threshing floor of Ornan the Jebusite. Let's remember Genesis 12:1. Now the Lord had said to Abram, Get thee out of thy country, and from thy kindred, and from thy father's house, unto a land that I will show thee. From this same city site of Salem, Abraham made offering to God through the high priest Melchizedek, the priest who had no beginning or end, and whom Paul declared Jesus after his order. Obedient, Abraham returned here again to Mount Moriah, Jehovah Jireh, to sacrifice his only begotten son. Now all future sacrifices at the temple site from David and Solomon in Jerusalem will point forward to the same location of that once and for all sacrifice of God's only begotten son, his sinless son. Do you see the sacred picture of the tabernacle again? Holiness is uncompromising. God cannot allow sin or unrighteousness in his sight. We in this world are veiled from his presence. Repentance, prayer, and good deeds do not take away sins and do not allow one into the presence of God. Only blood makes atonement. For in the blood is life. The Levites were allowed to eat from burnt offerings, and the Israelites ate the Passover lamb. But never the blood. It was reserved for God. Innocent blood was reserved. Righteous blood. Like Adam and Eve, we have nothing to offer. Our blood is unrighteous. When you come to this altar, this sacred place, the blood sacrifice of his son is continually before the eyes of God. Jesus, our high priest, has already entered into his Father's presence and placed his blood before and on the mercy seat. God's love is in his grace. A just and holy God requires mercy to precede grace. That is because mercy is not receiving what is deserved, and grace is receiving what is not deserved. Praise be to the Holy Spirit, and glory to God in the highest, and honor to the one who received what you and I deserve. Who painted these pictures in the history of the chosen people? Jesus asked Peter, "Who do you say I am?" Like Adam and Eve, are you trying to hide? I challenge you to watch the Lamb.
Thank you.
got the sign, so I think we're ready for the dramatization of Watch the Lamb, and Mark Reed will be singing. I mean, just... Walking on the road to Jerusalem, the time had come for sacrifice again. My two small sons, they walked beside me on the road. The reason that they came was to watch the Lamb. Daddy, Daddy, what will we see there? There's so much that we don't understand. So I told them of Moses and Father Abraham. Then I said, dear children, watch the Lamb. For there will be so many in Jerusalem today. We must be sure the Lamb doesn't run away. And I told them of Moses, Father Abraham. Then I said, dear children, watch the Lamb. When we reached the city, I knew something must be wrong. There were no joyful worshipers, no joyful worship songs. I stood there with my children in the midst of angry men. And then I heard the crowd cry out, crucify him! We tried to leave the city, but we could not get away. Forced to play in this drama, a part I did not wish to play. Why upon this day were men condemned to die? Why were we standing here where soon they would pass by? I looked and said, even now they come. The first one cried for mercy, the people gave him none. The second one was violent, he was arrogant and loud. I can still hear his angry voice screaming at the crowd. Then someone said, there's Jesus, and I scarce believe my eyes. A man so badly beaten,
he barely looked alive. Blood poured from his body, from the thorns upon his brow, running down the cross and falling to the ground. I watched him as he struggled. I watched him as he fell. The cross came down upon his back. The crowd began to yell. In that moment, I felt such agony. In that moment, I felt such loss. Until a Roman soldier grabbed my arm and screamed, "You carry his cross." At first, I tried to resist him. Then his hand reached for a sword. So I knelt and took the cross from the Lord. I placed it on my shoulder and started down the street. The blood that he'd been shedding was running down my cheek. They led us to Golgotha. They drove nails deep in his feet and hands. Yet upon the cross I heard him pray, "Father, forgive them." Oh, never have I seen such love in any other eyes. Into thy hands I commit my spirit, he prayed, and then he died. I stood for what seemed like years. I lost all sense of time until I felt two tiny hands holding tight to mine. My children stood there weeping. I heard the elders say, "Father, please forgive us." The lamb ran away. Daddy, Daddy, what have we seen here? For there's so much that we don't understand. So I took them in my arms. We turned and faced the cross. And then I said, "Dear children, watch the Lamb."
Thank you. gracious Father, the author and the finisher of our faith. We do praise you, Father, for the price that Christ paid. And Father, we praise you too and thank you for the dramatization and for the words and the music that we've heard this morning that has brought this home to us again. Now, Father, we ask you to bless each and every one that has chosen to be here this morning. And may this dramatization and may these words find a lodging place within the heart, and we might carry this word to those that have never heard it. For we ask it all in Jesus' name. Amen.
What are they doing?
They're swimming, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, they have to swim and get a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. They have to eat as fast as they can.
Oh, is this that thing with the kids racing?
Wow, the crazy kids.
Oh. I'll go see if the girl. Is this where the girls are?
Yeah.
What you doing?
Do
oh, hey.
Oh.
Look at there.
This is your station.
There's Holly. Holly.
Erin, this is yours, oh, honey. Happy Easter.
What do you say?
Chelsea, this is yours.
I'm going to the and open up, guys.
Or you can do it on the table. Whatever you want, honey, okay?
Yeah, they're kids. They sit on the floor.
I bet it's yours. It look, look on an egg. Does it have your name on an egg?
Whoa. Oh, you're just there. How cute.
There's
Betty. I've got
coupons in
what?
Wow.
Ooh, those are animals.
What do you guys got over here?
Look at all the animals.
Yeah. Okay. Like Jeremy Fisher, we have this one.
Oh, good.
And another pretty egg.
Now, Erin, you got to open those.
Uh-oh. There's something in this one.
You can open that one.
I
want to
do this.
No, just wait.
Just wait.
What's
this? You know what this is?
Bubbles. What all did you get there, Ash? A bunch?
Yeah. Oh, Mom, I got two things.
Okay, we'll put your eggs in another bag, okay?
Say that again, dear. Let me get that close-up sarcastic remark.
That must be your rubber band.
I'm mine.
Here you go, buddy. Why won't you go find Easter eggs?
They're in this room and the computer room.
Okay, let's go in here. Yeah, let's go in the other room.
Now, when you
get four, Holly,
I'll show
you where they're at.
My
now. Oh, yeah,
they're not in that bathroom. They're in the living room, and they're in the computer room.
Hey, Grandma, I found more than one or two or three or four.
Put it in your bucket.
Sorry. You finding any, Chelsea?
Hey, I'll help you guys. I got four.
Where you going?
Here, here's one.
Look high, look low.
What's up here? Looky up here.
Can't see. Let's
buy that.
You see it?
Yeah.
You have four, Holly?
Look high and low. In and out. Up and down.
Yep, yep.
Now you can sit here at the table and open your eggs and see what you got, Brandon, if you like.
So if you find four,
everybody got four.
You only got three?
Oh, you only got three.
Chippy,
Holly.
Come here,
Chippy.
I got four.
Come
here. Erin, you want to go see what's inside your eggs?
Yeah.
Now you put the bowls on the kitchen table, guys. Ready? You want to find one more in here?
Erin, where are you at?
Here he comes.
Hi, buddy. I'm taking some stuff.
Brandon found that one.
Okay. Don't act so excited, Brandon.
Can you open this?
Hi, Pumpkin.
Hi.
Oh, I'm
you're
sorry.
You're the center of attention when we're videoing.
Hi, Pumpkin.
You'd be surprised the montage we got of you at home.
Hey. Yeah. Come on, Lauren. Let's see you do something. Get up and run.
Lauren.
Everyone, hurry, hurry, snap the picture. She's excited.
Grandma got it. I got it. Yeah, I did. I got it. Yeah.
Golly.
You're not very happy, are you? Are you a happy girl?
Let me think.
Lauren, are you a happy girl? Lauren. Hey,
she's looking
ashy. You giving her the eyelash or something?
13. Making
that funny face.
Get it
up and down. Oh, Lauren. Lauren.
Hey, come back.
She's getting into the golf, I think. Yoo-hoo.
Lauren.
Baby Dobin.
Go over here to Aunt Debbie. Ah! Yeah, she is funny.
Oh, hush.
I need the lion.
What do you need?
The lion.
Oh, am I on it? Entertainer, Ash.
I remember 2 years ago at this tournament, on the driving range, we stood behind.
She is into that golf, let me tell ya.
Look at Uncle Gary.
Well, that's enough to make you laugh out loud.
Careful, man.
Yeah.
You gonna play ball with her?
Yeah. Okay. Her dress is two different colors.
Roll the ball to her.
There's Grandpa back there. What's he doing? Oh, yeah. Oh. All these people. Yeah. I'm so entertained.
Oh, the bunny's riding the ball now.
Let me see you cry. Oh. Dirk was playing with the bee. Go play with Lauren.
Chelsea, watch out.
Ooh, nice hair, Chels. That was mean. Oh, still Lauren, your teddy bear?
Sure, your dollar.
Say money.
Show your dolly, dear. That might help.
Oh, well. Lauren.
Look at the dollar, Lauren.
What you doing with that? What you doing with that ball?
Oh my.
Look at the dollar. Oh, I thought she was going to get all excited there when she saw that dollar.
Get your LSS credit card out. That'll excite her.
No, her Gymboree. Your children's place credit card. She'll go, we're talking about Lauren.
Peek-a-boo.
Where'd you go?
Can you do it again?
Can you do this?
Where'd you go?
Where'd you go?
Huh?
Normally, she likes
to.
No, we can't flip her all the way over. She likes to be held upside down, though. Ready?
Oh, rush that blood to my head.
Peek-a-boo.
The blood, the blood.
We only do it a couple of times because we don't want to make you sick. And we don't do it after you eat.
Why?
Why?
She'll spit up. Kind of like Aaron did in the kitchen.
Yeah, but he throwed up.
Probably not that bad. Except for on the smaller scale. Hey, Chelsea, where's your mom? Where's your mom?
Are you comfy?
No.
Goosey, Ashley?
I want to buy something.
Can we get your bottle ready?
It's going to have to be entertaining, Ash. I have to entertain her.
Yeah, she's too big. She's getting to be pretty big, though, isn't she? She gets heavy, doesn't she?
Ha 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 ha
Oh, there you go. Here we go.
You see? Uh-oh. I'm going to see her spit up when she's up there at the top.
Where's your army man?
Yeah, right over there.
Okay.
Look at Addie all covered up.
Don't push off the stick. Get away, Chuck. You get out of my way, Chuck. Well, I tell ya.
And you got 11 and a half foot sliding. Said he heard something. Too late. He watched his tree drop on top of his sliding. So it
Break.
Busted that up.
Hey, Eddie's got a good potty. Why don't you go take a good potty? We get that on film? Eddie's got a good potty?
No. Oh, I got the words.
Play is good. It is. That's the other
dance. Get in there, Nick!
He's out.
No!
We whipped in front of everybody. What whip? Like, quit acting like a baby. Baby.
Hang on to it.
Get to the bag. Get to the bag.
Got it.
All right.
Good throw. Good throw.
Got a boy, Brandon.
Way to go, man.
Okay. Yeah. Boy. All right, come back now. Come on, Nick.
What's your name?
We are both named.
Cover it.
I bet Uncle Robin holds that. He's not me.
Okay. Look at good pitch. Good pitch. Get there, Brandon.
Way to get the out, guys!
Tagged him.
Oh, yeah.
Watch your runner, boys. Watch your runner. Too late at night. Maybe not Travers anymore. Yeah!
Good job!
Watch it, man. Watch it.
Attaboy. Attaboy. Attaboy, attaboy!
Good eye, Brandon, good eye! Look him over!
Atta boy. Be real quick.
You guys gotta swing low.
Try, Brand.